Hello, grade 8 students. In this video, we're going to talk about characteristics of the specific immune response. This is chapter 1, activity 5, the characteristics of the specific immune response. In this video, we will differentiate between the primary and the secondary immune response regarding the latency period, the amount of antibodies secreted, and also about the duration of the response, about the time this response will stay in the body. So we will differentiate between primary and the secondary immune response. So first, what is the primary immune response and what is the secondary immune response? The primary immune response, you have to keep it in mind that it's the immune response upon the first contact with the pathogen. So primary immune response, it's the immune response upon the first contact with the pathogen, whether it's bacteria, a virus, a parasite, or whatever. So the first time, the first contact with this pathogen is referred as the primary immune response. Whereas the secondary immune response, it's the immune response upon the second contact, but with the same antigen or with the same pathogen. So primary immune response, as I said, is the immune response upon the first contact with the pathogen, whereas the secondary immune response, it's the immune response upon the second contact with the same pathogen. Okay? Let's see this figure. First, we have the recognition of the antigen, first step of the activation. Second step, we have the multiplication. Also, it's called the amplification or the proliferation, the increase in the number of the immune cells. And then we have differentiation, the third step. So first step in the process is the antigen recognition or the recognition of the antigen. Second step, it's the multiplication of the immune cell or the proliferation or their amplification. You notice here they increased in number. And then the differentiation. Either they differentiate into antibody secreting cells or memory cells. And we will discover what's the function of the memory cells. And this will be the effector cells. Antibody secreting cells will become the effector cells, and memory cells, we will talk about them in the coming slides. So you have to know that multiplication is also referred as the proliferation or amplification. Both they have the same meaning, increase in number. Antibody secreting cells, from now on, they are called the plasma cells. So antibody secreting cells, they are antibodies, but the effector, they are B cells, sorry, but the effector B cells, they are called the plasma cell. So the mature and the effector B cell that's able to secrete antibodies is called plasma cell. During differentiation step, a cell will differentiate either into an effector cell that's able to secrete antibodies in the case of B lymphocytes, or that's able to kill other cells like the case of T lymphocytes. So during differentiation, a cell differentiates either to effector cell like plasma cell or the effector T cell, or it differentiates into memory cells. Memory, they will be kept to be used in the second time, and we will know exactly what's the function of the immune cells. So as I said, effector B cells, they are called the plasma cells that are able to secrete antibodies. So we call them the antibody secreting cells. Whereas the effector T cells, they are called the killer cells. Okay? Here, the graph is showing the amount of the antibodies in AU, arbitrary units, as a function of time in days. This is the graph showing we inject the antigen at time zero. We inject the antigen here at this time. So the first response is called the primary immune response. While at time 50 days, we inject the same antigen for the second time. So the immune response would be the secondary immune response. Let's see here. Let's start with the latency. What is the latency? The latency is the time needed for the immune response to start. Here, in the primary immune response, the time needed for the immune response to start represents about 10 days. This is the latency. While in the secondary immune response, it takes 2 or 3 days. Let's say 2 to 3 days to start. Okay, here. So we started from the second injection. So the immune response, the secondary immune response, it takes about 2 to 3 days to start. Whereas the primary immune response, it takes 10 days. So this is what is called latency. So the latency is the time needed for the immune response to start. In the primary immune response, it takes about 10 days. Whereas in the secondary immune response, it takes about 2, maximum 3 days. So which one is faster? Sure, it's the secondary immune response. Let's see here the amount of antibodies. In the primary immune response, the amount of antibodies, it was 2 arbitrary units, 2 AU. Whereas in the secondary immune response, the amount of antibodies is high. It reaches about 6 AU. So the primary immune response, low amount of antibodies, 2 AU. While the secondary immune response, high amount of antibodies, 6 AU. So the primary response, low amount of antibodies, while the secondary immune response, high amount of antibodies. Let's move now to the duration of the immune response. The duration of the immune response, let's say it started at day 10 and it finishes at day 40, let's say. So what do we call this? This is called a short duration. So as we said, the primary immune response, it started day 10 and it ends at day 40. So it has about 30 days of function. So it, duration is about 30 days. Okay, so we have protection for about 30 days. Whereas the secondary immune response, it started at day 52, for example. Okay, so it starts at 52. It ends at 90. So it's approximately 38 to 40 days. So it's a longer duration of protection. So the primary immune response, shorter duration of protection or response, whereas the secondary immune response, longer duration of protection and response. So here, the primary immune response, as I said, short duration of response, low amount of antibodies, and it takes a longer time to start. So it started about day 10, let's say. Whereas the secondary immune response, longer duration of response and protection, high amount of antibodies, and it starts after about 5 days of the second injection. So here, this table is showing the comparison between the primary and the secondary immune response regarding the latency, which is the time needed to start the immune response, the amount of antibodies, and the duration of the response. So the primary immune response, as we know, it has a long latency, so it needs a longer time to start, whereas the secondary immune response, it needs a shorter time. Here, I'm going to solve this table and complete it according to the exercise found. Okay, so primary immune response, it has a long duration, about 12 days, whereas the secondary immune response, it has a short duration, about 5 days, short time. Amount of antibodies, low amount of antibodies in the primary, whereas high amount of antibodies in the secondary. Duration of the response, it's short in the primary immune response, while it's longer duration and longer protection in the secondary immune response. So you have to keep in mind that primary immune response takes a long time to eliminate the infection, but it produces specific memory B and T cells. These B and T cells will be used in the secondary immune response. That's why secondary immune response will take a shorter time and it's more efficient. Why? Because of these memory cells. Because we have memory B and T cells from the primary. So we have, for example, like a reservoir of B and T cells. They are ready to attack the pathogen. So the immune response will be faster, will be more efficient, and will be more protective for a longer duration of time. And this is the importance of the memory. So what are the results of the primary immune response? It eliminates the foreign antigens and it produces memory B or T cells. That's why, for example, if I had a flu virus, the first time I get the virus, it needs about 7 to 8 days to eliminate this virus. While upon the second encounter of the same antigen, which is the flu virus, it takes about 3 to 4 days. This means that the secondary immune response is more efficient. What are the advantages of the secondary immune response? It's faster, less delay, meaning that it starts faster, high amount of antibodies, and stays for a longer duration of time.